All right, sir, that is 7 swans a-swimming, 6 geese a-laying, 4 calling birds, 3 French hens, 2 turtle doves, and 1 partridge hold the pear tree. Is there anything else I can get for you?
Oh, yeah. A bib. Furries. Only a few more days until Christmas, so you know what that means. Stress, 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 Christmas, stress, Christmas, stress, Christmas, stress, 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 Christmas, stress, Christmas, stress, Christmas, stress, 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 Christmas, stress, Christmas, stress, Christmas. Honestly, for being the most wonderful time of the year, it just stresses me the heck out, man. I mean, from making sure you have enough food to getting your decorations up and picking the right tree and... I mean, even trying to get around in the suburbs is a pain because of shopping zombies.
Credit cards. Lay away. Bread. Bargain.
Not to mention the stress of trying to make sure you have the right gift for everybody. Oh, I tell you, this boomerang is the perfect gift for Openhead Jimmy. All right. Doesn't have any hands. And I feel terrible because at this time of year, you know what gets to me the most? Christmas cards. You know what? I suck at them. I suck. I always forget to send them out. I never send them out. So every time I get a Christmas card from somebody else, it's a reminder of what a horrible, horrible person I am. Please do not send me Christmas cards anymore because they just make me feel worthless. And I know. Regardless of whatever I tell myself, Facebook messages, tweets, and texts are not Christmas cards.
You should try taking a walk in a winter wonderland.
Yeah, right, winter wonderland. You know what? In Chicago this year, we've had one day of significant snowfall, and it was gone 2 days later. Right now, in the last few days, it's been raining, just raining and wet and damp, and that, boy, yeah, that sure helps me clear up my stress this time of year.
Spiggs, you need to chill out.
Hey, you're gonna have a heart attack.
Yeah, just take a pill and try to remember why we do this. See, even before all the major religions had holidays around the winter solstice, the Midwinter Festival was already important to prehistoric cultures. It was the last feast before the deep winter set in. See, January to April were typically considered the famine months, when resources would start to run thin. So the Midwinter was the we might not make it to spring fling. Plus, all the wine and beer that was made in the summer had finally fermented and early pagans could get their buzz on.
I hear that. Up top. Oh, right.
You know, I suppose that the prospect of dying in the deep winter does put my holiday grumbling in perspective. And by the way, I am hardly the worst Christmas complainer that I've ever heard. I hate Christmas music. The only good Christmas music are the 19th century English carols. Anything else, anything that came out in the 20th century is just an insipid ode to gluttony, greed, and commercialism.
It's Gnarlsby, the art house film dork that ripped my ear.
So, I guess, in the end, the stress is kind of worth it, especially when you're doing it for those you love. And whether you're celebrating the last feast of the midwinter or commemorating the rededication of the second temple in Jerusalem in the 2nd century BC for 8 days starting on the 25th of Kislev, or celebrating the birth in a stable of a child who would eventually grow up and change the world. However it is that you want to spend this time of year with family and friends, just take a deep breath. It's almost over. So from all of us to all of you, we just want to say Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and... It's you.
Hey, Lisa here with the Lisa J. Moore Channel from Dallas, Texas, and I'm proud to be a furry. But I'm kind of confused, because I'm not very furry at all. I do love you, Spiggitz.